Hi, this is Reggie with the Fortify On Demand team. Today I'm going to be providing a short demonstration on how to download the Eclipse plugin for Fortify On Demand and to upload a project using that plugin and then to download results from Fortify On Demand once a scan has completed. When you land in the portal, the first thing you'll want to do is click on your name and then select Tools. On the tools page, you'll see several of the plugins and tools available that work with Fortify On Demand. There are more integrations and tools. If you click on this link to the Fortify On Demand marketplace, there are several open source tools and other things, tools that weren't necessarily developed by us. This is the bulk of the tools that you'll use. So the first thing we want to get for the Eclipse plugin is this update site URL. We're going to take that into Eclipse. We're going to click on Help, Install New Software. Right up here is where we would put that URL. The first time you add that, you're going to want to click Add. You can give it a name, set the location, and click Add, and it will go and load those up. So there are actually four sub items here, but we're just going to want to select everything. Click Next. This will check for any dependencies that you need. Click Next again. Accept the terms of the license agreement and click Finish. This will install the software in Eclipse. Once finished, you'll be asked to restart the IDE to apply the changes. Click Restart Now. Once Eclipse restarts, you'll notice you have a new menu item across the top. You've got this Fortify menu item. There's a few options in it, but you'll notice that upload projects to Fortify On Demand, which is the first thing that we're going to look at, is grayed out. What I need to do is actually select I need to have my Package Explorer open and select something over here. At that point, you'll be able to upload a project to Fortify On Demand. Now you'll note that because I selected Auth Bypass here, under Selected Projects, the only option that I have is Auth Bypass. So what I'm going to do is cancel, because let's say I need to upload either much or all of this. To do so, I would just hold down Shift and select All. Now, to make sure that my upload goes relatively quickly, I'm not going to do everything, but I'll just take two to show you, or I'll take you through two, yes, two to show you that in action. So I'm going to select two over here. Instead of just the one, I can select as many as I'd like, upload projects to Fortify On Demand, and now you'll notice that I have two options here. Everything that you select over there will be available. So I'm going to leave all of the other default options selected here and click Next. At this point, I am going to have to log in to the portal. This will default to the correct URL for you, so don't change that. You'll just enter your username, your password, and your tenant ID. Click Next. Now it's downloading a list of applications and releases that I have access to in the portal. So I'm going to choose Goat Eclipse. I'm going to set my technology stack to Java. Under Advanced, I can choose my audit preference. I'm going to set that to Automated. And I'm not going to include third-party libraries. I'm going to click Finish. And at this point, it's going to export and upload my payload to the Fortify On Demand portal. Now that I've uploaded a project, what I'm going to do is download results from a scan. So to do that, I'm going to select Fortify, Open Analysis Results. Now, if I haven't logged in, I'm going to be asked to provide this information again. Now, if you're not sure of the API root URL, if it doesn't populate for you, just wanted to show you a way that you can always get it. If you click on your name again in the Fortify On Demand portal and then click on API Explorer, you can take the root here. You won't want slash swagger slash UI slash index, but everything else you would put in there. And then you can enter your credentials. Click next. And once again, just like when I was uploading, now I get a selection of my past results. So I can choose my goat Eclipse, for example, here. Now, this is not the project that I just uploaded. This is one that I had run previously. But you can see here, I get all of my vulnerabilities by default group by category, just like in the portal. If you assign users in the portal, you can check. You can sort them by assigned users. If you're an auditor and you want to assign them, I can select a vulnerability. And I can assign this to a user. Now, unfortunately, I have several, but I can just run down this, for example. And assign these two vulnerabilities out. Now, Reginald Brown sees, okay, these vulnerabilities are assigned to me. And I can run through them and see, in this case, I have a hard-coded password vulnerability. I'm sorry, this is password in configuration file, slightly different vulnerability. I can see an analysis trace. Now, in this case, there's only going to be one item in that trace. So let's go to one that has multiple items in a trace. So typically something like a null dereference will have potentially multiple items in our trace, and we do here. So we've got our assignment statement up here. And then where it is dereferenced there. I'm going to close this section to expand this a little bit. Over here, I get my abstract and explanation of my null dereference vulnerability, and I can view recommendations to fix it. So that's the Fortify On Demand plugin for Eclipse. Thank you, and have a great day.